When you consider Hashem as a father, as a mother, he will be next to you.
Rishut Moray v'Rabotai, with the permission of Rabino Akiva, with your permission, I would like today to talk a little bit about Purim and about the Mishkan, the Tabernacle. I would like to explain the connection that there is between Purim and the Beit HaMikdash. There is a big, and what it is the learning, what we can learn from all this. Of course, there is a lot of things to learn from Purim, from the Mishkan, everything. First, if we talk about Purim, there is a mitzvah that each Jew should bring mahatzit shekel, half shekel. So, what it is the reason that the Jews, they have to bring the half of shekel? Because at when the Beit HaMidrash, when we had the Beit HaMikdash, there was a lot of expensive, you know. You have, the expensive, like today. Today, for a synagogue, you need to pay for the electricity, to pay for the people who clean the synagogue. You have to pay the, the rent, or you have to pay, the entry, and l'entretien, to entertain, the place, you need money. You have to pay the rabbi, you have to pay the shaliach tzibur, it is expensive. So all the community, they pay, all the membership of the community, they give each one whatever he can give. So all the money, it's for the expensive of for the synagogue. Otherwise, the synagogue will close. So for the Beit HaMikdash was the same. The Beit HaMikdash, there were a lot of sacrifice for the tzibur, korbanit tzibur. Like there were a sacrifice in the morning, a sacrifice in the evening, and the korban tamid. And there is all kind of sacrifice. There was a lot of expensive. The bread, to pay the people who bring the wood. I mean, it was a lot. So for all that money, from where they get it? All the money they get it from the once a year on the month of Adar, the first of Adar, Mashmi'in al Ashkalim. What that means, Mashmi'in al Ashkalim? They make, if you see the Mishnah of Shkalim, it said that we sent the Beit Din, sent people all around Israel to make an announcement. Hey, today we have to prepare ourselves to bring it's like on the first of Adar, public announcement is made concerning the payment of the shekel. No, everyone had to bring to prepare themselves mashmi'in. They make an announcement, mashmi'in to an announcement to bring the shekelim for the Beit HaMikdash. Okay, so why this? Because Hashem. That Hashem will forgive the Egel, the Avodah Zarah that the Jews did after they received the Torah. So once a year, so Hashem decided to build, that there should be a house of Hashem, the Mishkan. And the expense of the Mishkan, it should be the Jews who will pay. Now, let's say if there is a billionaire man, who will come to the Beit HaMikdash, who will say to the Beit Din, oh, I want to take all the expensive on me. I want to give you $1 million. I want to give you 10 million of shkalim. All the expensive, all this year, it's on me. Can we listen to him or not? No, he's not allowed. A rich man, he will bring half shekel. A poor man, he will bring half shekel, only half. So there will be a lot of halves, millions of halves. And with all that money, we keep them during all year for the expenses of the Beit HaMikdash. All kind of sacrifice that the Beit HaMikdash need, there is money of the tzibur, of the public, of the community, that a rich man is not allowed to bring more than half shekel, a poor man is not allowed to say, I am poor, I can't bring. This is his problem, this is his problem, he should provide the half shekel. Because every Jew should have the Beit HaMikdash, he should have his portion on the korbanot. There is few korbanots every day, there is a lot of expensive on the Beit HaMikdash, so each Jew, he must have a portion on that expensive. You understand?
Yeah.
Now we understand why we should bring the Mahatita Shekel. Now, Mishinichnas Adar Marbim Bisimha. When the month of Adar starts, we have to increase joy. We have to increase. Why? The question is why. Why? What it is the reason? Why we have to increase joy? Why? There is a lot of reasons. First, we have to increase joy to say thank you to Hashem for the miracles that he did with us against Haman. That Haman wanted to kill the Jews. And Baruch Hashem, Haman, instead of killing the Jews, he was hung. And Baruch Hashem, the Jews, they've been together, they've been in Ahdut, and thanks to Haman, the Jews did a big teshuva. And thanks to Haman, there is a lot of mitzvot that they were not existing, and now because of Haman, so there is a lot of mitzvot that we do them only because of Haman. And there is another mitzvah, another joy, on when we saw the big miracle that Hashem did with us during the time of Mordechai and Esther, so the old Jews saw how much Hashem loves us. So the Jews, they say to Hashem, Hashem, from now on, we will love you. So they discovered that Hashem loved them. So automatically, they were so excited about Hashem. He said, Hashem, now really we love you. Not only we love you, we love the Torah. We will do anything you want from us. So ki imu v'kiblu. So that means I saw the Sfat Emet who said that why the Jewish people during Matan Torah they did not receive the Torah with happiness, with joy. The Sfat Emet, he said, because of Amalek. Because Amalek, he created doubt. Amalek, he came before Matan Torah. Amalek came to fight the Jews before the Jews received the Torah. And he created doubt in the world. So because it created doubt in the world, so the Jews, they received the Torah, but not at 100% of joy. So now, when the Bnei Israel, they saw that the grandson of Amalek, all what happened to him at the end, so really, that was the tikkun, that was the reparation, that they received the Torah with doubt, not with doubt, with not a lot of joy. But now, when they saw how much Amalek wanted to do bad to them, was bad to them, and he wanted to harm them, and Hashem protect them from Haman, so now really they repair, they receive the Torah again with simcha, with happiness, with willing, with ratzon. Now we understand why when Adar, the month of Adar came, we have to increase simcha, joy, because of what happened. Because the month of Adar as well, it has another signification. Adar is from the word dira. Adar is from a house. On Adar, we prepare ourselves. We prepare ourselves there. Adar is dira, it's a house. We prepare our body to be the house of Hashem. Automatically, when you are happy of all what happened to our parents, and if God forbid, something bad would happen to our parents, we would not be today here. So Baruch Hashem, so every year, I am here, I'm today here. So Baruch Hashem, I want to to contribute my body, my own body to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So, dear, I give my body to Hashem to respect Torah and mitzvot, and thank you Hashem for all what you did to us. Okay. So now we just explain what it is, what we do in Adar, on the month of Adar, the joy that we have to be, the preparation for to receive the Pesach as well, because Pesach is a preparation to be a free man, and Ben Hurim is on Pesach, and you see on Pesach we feel free, but that means on the month of Adar we nearly been killed, and now Baruch Hashem, He protects us from Haman, so now we prepare ourselves to be not only free physically, but free spiritually. So Pesach come, we feel free. Now we are willing to accept anything Hashem you want us to accept. And Pesach is as well a big preparation for Matan Torah. So you see, it's a Purim, Purim, Pesach and Shavuot. All of this, it's a real preparation to be a good Jew. Purim, to say thank you to Hashem. Purim, it's we prepare ourselves to a lot of preparation to all this, to be a free man, to be, it's like step by step. From Purim, you start your preparation for Ben Hurim, to be a free man, so you can be receive the Torah while you are free, physically and spiritually, to receive HaKadosh Baruch. But on Purim, on Adar, we open our heart, we open our door to Hashem. On Purim, we have, on Pesach, we are free men, to prepare now myself to receive the Torah. Shavuot came, it's Matan Torah. So now, my friend, I have one question, a big question. We said that Be'adam mashmi'in al hashkalim. On Adar, we send, the building sent people, send the messenger, people, to announce, oh, it's a public announcement, people, they should prepare themselves to give the shekel, the half shekel, for the temple. Now you should know one thing. This half shekel that we give to the temple is very significant. Why? Because through this half shekel, we do all the sacrifice on the temple, the Beit HaMikdash. All the sacrifice bring you happiness, health, wealth, all kind of brachot in the world. So I do not understand. You understand, Akiva? I don't understand how it's possible that the Beit Din should make a special announcement, a public announcement, that every Jew should bring the half shekel. I mean, it's like somebody who take medication, and if he don't take the medication, he might die. Do you have to remind him, hey, take medication? No, he knows. Look, I take medication. I have some medication that I have to take all my life. I have to, for the diabetes and for the cholesterol, all my life, every day, twice a day. Do you need somebody to remind me to take them? No. If I don't take them, I make myself in danger. I mean, I don't understand why the Beit Din, they have to make a public announcement on Adar that everyone should bring the half shekel. What is this half shekel? It's nothing. And especially I know, through this half shekel, I will bring health, wealth, bracha to my family, to myself. Because when there is this kind of public sacrifice on the Beit HaMikdash, L'Reach Nehuah Ishel Hashem, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, when he see this the sacrifice that we do through our money, so HaKadosh Baruch Hu is happy with us, and he gives us all what we need. You don't forget, because the Jews, they did not sacrifice the Korban Tamid, the Nebuchadnezzar destroyed the temple, and the Romans destroyed the temple, because there was no more sacrifice in the temple. That means that the sacrifice that they were made in the temple, it protected Jerusalem, it protected the whole Jews. And once there was no sacrifice, no sheep anymore to sacrifice in the temple, Korban Tamid, all the Gezerot came. So, I mean, why did the Beit Din had to send to make special public special announcement that to bring concerning the payment of the shekel. I mean, who would dare not to bring the half shekel? And beside it, what it is a half shekel? It's nothing. Even a rich man, he bring only half shekel. And even a poor man, he bring only half shekel. So what the big deal? Why we have to make this kind of special public announcement? This is the question that I am asking. Now, beside this, there is another question. When Moshe Rabbeinu, he wanted to build the Mishkan, Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu, Moshe, only you can build the Mishkan. No one should help you. If you don't do it, so there'll be no Mishkan. So my question is, why Hashem didn't want that the Jews will participate to build the Mishkan? What the big problem of Hashem? It's good, it's a big mitzvah. Why Hashem didn't want? Why? Hashem said to Moshe, only you. There'll be no one else to build the Mishkan, only you. Why? So now we have two questions. Why only Moshe? He had the order to build the Mishkan himself. And why we have to make a special announcement to bring the Shkalim? My friend, I would like to tell you this. I read this morning that the half shekel that the Jews bring to the Mishkan for the payment, for the expenses of the Mishkan, was made only by the men, not the woman. The women, they were not obligated to bring the half shekel. Only the men. Why? Because the women, they did not do the egel. They did not do the avodah zarah in the desert. Only the men. And because of the men, who did avodah zarah, we needed the Mishkan. Because they did avodah zarah and we need the Mishkan, so they have to pay the expenses. But the women that they did not do avodah zarah, they are not obligation. They have no obligation to bring the half shekel. It's incredible, this. Incredible. Now, according to this, I was thinking something extraordinary. Something beautiful. I would like just to tell you this. That, I think, to have a shalom bayit is not easy. It's not easy. You don't forget, when a house, when there is a divorce, it's like a destruction of the temple. The Gemara said, when there is a divorce, even the Mizbeach cry for the divorce. You should know that Shalom Bayit, when there is peace in the house, especially on Friday, because on Friday there is a lot of tension in the houses, because especially on the winter, that the days are short. There is a lot of tension. You have to be very easy. A man should help his wife. The wife should make sure that she will not fight her husband if he don't come on time to house to help her. And the man should think that Friday there is a lot of work on Shabbat for Shabbat, so he must come a little bit early to help his wife. And beside this, during the week, for no reason, it could be a fight between a man and his wife. How much it's so important. That way, when a Jewish couple get married, we give them a bracha that their house will be binyan adead, will be a construction forever. A house, a Jewish house, that will be no destruction. A house with Hashem inside. And I think that the Jewish house, we call it Bet Yaakov, the house of Yaakov. And the house is like a Mishkan, a house where there is there a lot of sacrifice. A man that will make sacrifice not to fight his wife. A wife should make a sacrifice not to fight her husband. There was a rabbi one day that he was very, 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 very diabetic. Very diabetic. He was not allowed to drink, not diabetic, salt. He had the he had a lot of tension, oppression. So he's not allowed, a man who has oppression is not allowed to, he's not allowed to drink, to take salt, or to eat anything salted. So his wife, she always makes sure to give him sugar, and always when she cook his food, she will always made that she will not cook with salt for her husband. And one day she forgot. Instead of putting the coffee, the sugar on the coffee, she put salt. She put salt. So she bring the tea, the coffee or the tea to her husband, and her husband, what he did, so he will not make his wife ashamed, he drank the whole coffee. Till the end, it was very dangerous, but he didn't want to make to embarrass his wife. Then his wife, she saw that the cup was salted, and she said, oh, what I did. She ran away to her husband. Hey, Moshe, the coffee was salt. I put salt in your coffee. Said, no, my dear, you did not put salt in my coffee. It was sugar. Don't be afraid. Ah, thank you. You see, from this story, how much the respect should be between a man and her, and his wife. A man, sometimes there's mistakes. Not because of mistake you have to fight with your wife or the wife to the husband. So, we need a lot of, and beside this, Ish Isha. The name of Ish, there is a Yud. There is Yud in the middle of the name. Aleph Yud Shin. And Isha, there is He. Ish Aleph Shin He. If you take the Yud, you take the He, it's Yudke, the name of Hashem. And what remains Esh. That means when there is peace between the man and the husband and the wife, so there is the name of Hashem with them. The man of Hashem is with them. Hashem is with them. He lives with them the house. But when there is a fight between them, when there is Esh, fire between them, and they are excited, they fight like this today. A man or woman told me, Rabbi David, we have a big problem. We fight day and night. We don't know what to do, but we love each other. We don't want to divorce, but we fight. So I told them, well, Hashem is not in your house. You lost. You lost Hashem. He's not in your house. That's why there is no Parnassa, because they have no Parnassa. Hashem is not in the house. What the thing that you love each other and Hashem is not in the house, you fight all the time. Think all the time that if you want Hashem in the house, you have to be kind. You have to be calm in the house. If you don't want Hashem, so carry on fighting. Yes, you love each, and they will end up by a divorce. So you see, I think when you create, Moshe Rabbeinu, when he built the Mishkan, Hashem said to Moshe, this is not the time that everybody will help you to build the Mishkan. I want you to do a remark to the Jews, that each Jew, he is a house. Each Jew, it's man and woman, when they get married, they're building their house. And that their house will be Beit Hashem, a house of Hashem, a house of God. It will be a Mishkan, and it will be Shalom. There has to be patience. Teach them how you build the house. And if they build their house with Shalom, with happiness, so I will come to live with them. And that is the meaning. When once Moshe Rabbeinu, he finished building the Mishkan, he appeared, the presence of Hashem appeared. That means that Hashem, he appeared to the house when a couple are married, only when the intention is to live according to the Jewish law and Shalom. And I think this is the meaning, this is the message of Mishkan, Beit Hashem, Beit Yaakov. Yaakov is the woman. I mean, a house. Moshe Rabbeinu, it was an example. He wanted to teach them, hey man, look, this house of Hashem is going to be your house. And that your house will be always the house of Hashem. And the house really, a house that there will be always miracles. It's a miracle when a man doesn't answer his wife. when she wants to fight him. It's a miracle when a woman don't answer her husband when he fight her. When you do your best not to answer, so Hashem will remind the house, and Hashem will help you to make shalom and peace. But when a man fights, so Hashem, the house is without the name of Hashem, without the presence of Hashem. And what was going to be the end? The destruction of the house. I think this is the meaning. I mean, for that there is a lot of, because the Yetzara is big. The Yetzara is in the house. You have to watch out. The Yetzara will not let you, especially on Shabbat. The Yetzara knows that on Shabbat you will feel Hashem. On Shabbat it's Gan Eden. On Shabbat it's the taste of Shabbat, you never taste it in your life. The test is special. So the Yetzara will do everything to destroy that test. So make sure. Don't answer. Respect. And then you will win. What you will win? You will win that you will feel Shabbat. You will win that Hashem is still there. You will win everything. The peace. For that there is a lot of miracles. That's why the Gemara said that there were a lot. When Moshe Rabbeinu built the Mishkan, there was a lot of miracles. That it's opposite to build a Mishkan that it was heavy. So the message is not to answer your wife, not to answer your husband, to build your house according to the Torah. It's not easy. It's very hard. But you start, and Hashem will help you. Baruch Hashem. There was a big rabbi in Turkey. That he was living in a palace. So there were some rabbis that they came from Jerusalem, from Israel, to collect money. When they saw the rabbi, the beautiful house, so they asked him, this is the first time that we see a rabbi live like a king. So the rabbi told them, my house is not my house. This is the house of Hashem. Me and my wife, we never fight. Me and my wife and I, we live in a peace. And we know when there is peace in the house, there is Hashem in the house. So for Hashem, this beautiful house, not for us, not for our kavod, it's for Hashem. So the rabbis, the Jews from Jerusalem, they ask him pardon, sorry. We did not understand this meaning. Thank you. So you understand now, the Yetzara is so strong, is so mean, the Yetzara. He wants to destroy the house of Hashem when there is a fight between a man and a woman. So you have to be careful. You have to fight. You have to start. You have to do your effort. Don't answer. Patience. By starting, Hashem will help you to carry on. Then you won. A lot of times I did not answer my wife and I won. A lot of times I answered and I fight and I lost. For 1 month, not talking, I lost. Who knows? Maybe I lost a lot of things that I don't know about them. Now you understand, everything that there is a good thing, there is a Yetzara. Now, the Yetzara knows, the Satan knows as well, that the meaning of the Shkalim, the half shekel that you bring, he has something insignificant, something extraordinary, that through this half shekel that you bring, and through half shekel that every Jew bring, all the Jewish people, they become Ahdud, all together. All the Jewish people, they bring half shekel. So all this money is mixed. So each day, I have a portion of the sacrifice that is made in the Beit HaMikdash. And this portion, he united me with all the Jewish people. Because this korban, the sacrifice was made with the money of all Jewish people. So every day we live with Ahdut. And the Yetzara, I don't want Ahdut. He wants that we fight between us. That the rabbis will fight between them. Jewish people, they will fight between them. And if we fight between us, there is no, Hashem is not with us. So that's why, Mashmi'in, we make a public announcement. We make a public announcement because the Yetzara is so big. The Yetzara will say, well, I have time to bring my half shekel. Well, I will bring it next week. Well, and then you forget. Then you don't bring the half shekel. Then you are not among all the korbanot that they are made for for the world. And because of that, the Beit Din, they send a special people to make this public announcement everywhere. Hey, hey, big half shekel, now, now, kill. Then when you listen to this, Mashmi'in al Shkalim, every Jew, they know that they should not miss the half shekel to bring it. So they bring it. Otherwise, they will miss all year. Otherwise, who knows? So wherever there is a Tzara, Hashem, there is a special announcement. Wherever there is a Tzara who can bother, so we have to do, prepare something to avoid that we will not feel in the hand of the Tzara. It's like, and I would like to finish this. It's like, you know, that the Torah said that you're not allowed to have a relationship with your wife when she is nida. But Hachamim said, okay, you're not allowed, but the tzara is very big. Maybe by touching your wife, by giving her from your hand to her hand a glass, maybe from hand to hand, maybe you will come, and after a few days that you did not touch your wife, maybe you can come to do avera. So Hachamim said, well, even giving from your hand to her hand, don't do it. So you see, Hachamim, they did a gzera. They did not, so to make you like a protection, not to offend the hand of the Yetzirah. For Shlombayit, the Yetzirah is big. For the Hakamat HaMishkan, it's the meaning of building a house, building a Shlombayit. It's not easy, but you start. And after Hashem will help you. Start. And Hashem will open the Shalom Bayit. And the Yetzirah is very big when it comes to Tzedakah. When it comes to the Mahatzis HaShekel. So quick, Mashmi'a HaShekelim, we send a public announcement. Because through the Shekel, half Shekel that we do, Tzedakah Tatzimim Mavid, we put it ourselves from death. So you see, it's for our own good that Hashem, he said to bring to bring the Mahatz Shekel, and now you understand by not when the wives, when the woman at the time, they did not bring the Mahatz Shekel, everyone, every Jew, he think, well, we did the Egel, the woman, they did not the Egel, so we have to respect them. So you see, Hashem, you want us to remember that, hey, the woman, we should not let them and aside, we have to respect them. Because of them, we left Egypt. Because of them, our children studied the Torah. So the women have a special, we have to give them a special kavod, a special honor to the woman. And even the Egel, they did not participate in the Egel, and that's why they did not bring the Mahatz HaShekel. But we did the Egel, so we have to bring Mahatz HaShekel. So for that, we appreciate more women by looking how much they were tzadkaniyot. So you see how much HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he does everything for the Shalom Bayit. For Hashem, through Torah and Mitzvot that he gives us, he helps us to become a better man, a better person. Mishi nechnas Adar, ma'bi b'simcha. I would like just to finish. Mishi nechnas, when Adar comes, you have to increase joy. If I take the first letter of Mishi Nichnas and I take the last letter of Mishi Nichnas, it's Mem Samech. Samech Mem is the Satan. In the Kabbalah we call the Satan Samech Mem. That means, and what that means, what the meaning of this? What the Mishi Nichnas Adar Ma'abim Vizma? What the of Samech Ma'Samech Mem? Look, my friend, take the letters that we have left of Mishi Nechnas. Shin Nun Chaf Nun is the gematria of Tak. Tak is hit, Maka, Hak, Tak, Taki. That means something extraordinary. What the meaning of Taki? Hit. That means that the Satan, when the Samech Mem, he see that Adar came And you see that you prepare yourself now for to be a free man and to receive the Torah on Shavuot and to be free physically and spiritually from Purim till Shavuot. He will do anything to have you in his hand. So what you have to do to avoid him when at Marbim Bisimcha, you have to increase joy, and the Satan, he cannot stand the joy. When the Satan said Jew happy to do a mitzvah, he ran away from him. And that is the preparation. Mishin Nichnas Adar. When Adar come, the Samech Memi want to approach you. So what you should do? Take, hurt him. Throw him. How you can hurt him? By Simcha. Because the Satan is Amalek. When Amalek he see that you Adar is coming, he will do everything to bring on you doubt on Hashem, on Emuna, it will make you weak on Avodat Hashem and the service Hashem. So you have to fight him. How you fight him? Through Simcha. Mashmi'in al-Shkalim. Quick, that day, Adar came, we sent people, give Tzedaka, and Tzedaka protect you from death. Tzedaka protect you from the Tzara. And this is the meaning. I mean, Hashem, he does everything that a man should be always close to Hashem. So I hope, at Hashem, that this Torah that I said, it will be a learning from all of us to approach us to Avodat Hashem. And I wish you all the best. God bless you. על הרב דוד ביטו לילולה לסיטו על הרב דוד ביטו נודו יל עיילת סגרתו